Today's topic is what is laser circumcision and why it is actually going to be a bad circumcision to choose. In the reality, a laser circumcision is actually a bad choice in terms of healing. When we are using the high energy beam of a laser to cut the skin, what is actually happening is that the skin margins are being burnt. Because the skin margins are being burnt and the skin margins do not have any bleeding on them, what it leads to is that it leads to dead necrotic tissue. And when you seal both of these tissues together with the help of sutures, you end up with a bad scar. Because the area has died, the patient will notice more pain and pus formation. So laser circumcision should actually be discarded to the dustbin of history, because it is actually a very harmful method of doing a circumcision rather than an advantageous one. Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Dr. Vijayan Govinda Gupta, an andrologist and a circumcision specialist in New Delhi, India. Today's topic is what is laser circumcision and why it is actually going to be a bad circumcision to choose. So a laser circumcision basically means that the circumcision or the circumcision is being done with the help of an energy source, which is basically going to be a laser. The laser is going to be a laser which is going to be able to cut the skin, and this cutting of the skin is supposed to be bloodless, which is supposed to give the patient good cosmetic results. But in the reality, a laser circumcision is actually a bad choice in terms of healing. If you understand the concept of healing, healing always happens in alive tissues. So whenever a surgical cut or a surgical margin is made on any living tissue, the first step or the first fundamental thing is to preserve the blood supply of that tissue. So whenever a surgeon makes a cut on the skin anywhere in the body, that cut is always used a scalpel or it's always a sharp cut. By using a sharp surgical cut, the advantage gained is that the edges are always bleeding, and because of the edges are always bleeding, the healing is always rapid. The laser circumcision somehow, the people performing or choosing laser circumcision somehow feel that by making the incision bloodless, they will be able to give a good cosmetic result. But that cannot happen, because when we are using the high energy beam of a laser to cut the skin, what is actually happening is that the skin margins are being burnt. Because the skin margins are being burnt and the skin margins do not have any bleeding on them, what it leads to is that it leads to dead necrotic tissue. And when you seal both of these tissues together with the help of sutures, you end up with a bad scar, and this scar can cause many problems later. By burning away the margins of the skin, what you are leading up to is going to be a deformed, scarred circumcision scar. The healing is going to be delayed. The edges, which are normally going to heal together in 3 to 5 days, will actually take 10 to 15 days to heal. Because the area has died, the patients will notice more pain and pus formation. So because of this, the laser circumcision never really took off in any part of the world. Instead of laser circumcision, a regular circumcision is going to be more suitable, because the skin margins are cut with a sharp knife, allowing bleeding edges. Only the large bleeders are cauterized, and the healthy skin margins are sutured together, which usually heal away in 10 to 12 days. An alternative regular circumcision that is now picking up and out is now the standard of care for circumcision is something called as a ZSR circumcision. It is a circumcision stapler, and the advantage of this stapler is that instead of crushing or leading to the edges of the skin margin to become bad, this circumcision stapler basically just cuts away the skin with a sharp blade, and the healthy edges are close together with the help of a silicone staple. This has two advantages. One, because it's a quick surgery, there is no pain. Second, because the stapler is cutting away with a sharp knife, there is no damage to the skin margins. And third, because there is a silicone ring which holds the skin margins together loosely, the skin margins heal in a wonderfully, cosmetically non-scarring way. On the other hand, when we do a laser circumcision, you are cutting the skin away with the help of a laser, which causes burning and ragged edges. The laser will never cut the skin in a smooth, round fashion, leading to irregular edges. The burnt skin will cause pain, necrosis, pus formation, and will cause ugly scars. And the skin has to be held together with the help of sutures, which defeats the entire purpose of a stitchless circumcision. So if you're looking for a circumcision and cost is a constraint, then go for a regular circumcision, which is utilizing a knife and a stitch, because that will give you a more cosmetically acceptable result as compared to laser. And if you have the affordability to afford something better, then go in for a ZSR or a stapler circumcision rather than laser circumcision, because it will be able to give you a cosmetically superior result in comparison to laser. So laser circumcision should actually be discarded to the dustbin of history, because it is actually a very harmful method of doing a circumcision rather than an advantageous one. If you understand the concept behind laser circumcision and you have more doubts about it, my comment section is open for comments. You can always write to me on Facebook or on WhatsApp to get your doubts cleared. If you want to get a ZSR circumcision for your phimosis or for your foreskin needs, then you can always connect with me on WhatsApp, Facebook, and other platforms on which I'm available. Thank you for listening in. Please like the video, subscribe to my channel. Take care. Regards.